Hello, Gnana students. Welcome to the social science class about ancient civilization of the world. In this chapter, children, you are going to learn the learning points are the Egyptian civilization, the Mesopotamian civilization, and the Chinese civilization. Generally, we can get water and favorable weather condition on the banks of the rivers for leading life. Many other civilizations flourished in various parts of the world at the time of Indus Valley civilization. We can see the Egyptian civilization, Mesopotamian civilization, and Chinese civilization in Asia and Africa. Let us view the Egyptian civilization. The Egyptian civilization could take birth due to the presence of the River Nile. Let us view their contributions. The Egyptians were expert farmers. They knew a lot of about irrigation. They had built temples. They invented the calendar, which has helped us to measure time. More than anything else, they had mastered the art of writing. It was a symbolic language. It consists of small drawings and has been called hieroglyphics. Now let us observe the Nile Valley. Means every rainy season, the Nile River would transform the Nile Valley into a huge lake. This fertile land provided food for the population of the first town in the area. Hence, through small canals and wells, they were responsible for the development of a complex system of irrigation throughout the land. The role of priest was created to interpret nature and explain it. They believed in life after death. The priest considered that life on earth was temporary and was needed only to prepare for the next life. The dead body would be smeared with the various chemicals and wrapped with a thin cloth. The entire body was in this way preserved. The body protected thus was called a mummy. It would be kept in a specially designed coffin. In the beginning, graves were created by carving into the rocks in the hills. Egyptians moved north. They had to construct graves in the desert itself. Kings and wealthy people vied with each other to build taller and taller towers. The Greeks called these structures as pyramids. The kings of Egypt were called pharaohs. Pharaoh means a person who lives in a palatial house. Later, Egypt was ruled over by an Arabian shepherd tribe called Hyksos, ruled for 500 years, but not popular. Later in 1700 BCE, the people of Egypt became free once again. Then the Persian emperor Cambyses occupied Egypt in the 6th century BCE. Alexander occupied Persia in the 4th century BCE. Egypt became a province of Macedonia. One of the Alexander's military generals declared himself the king of Egypt and established the dynasty of the Ptolemy. He founded the city of Alexandria. At last came the Romans in 39 BCE. The last Egyptian queen is Cleopatra, tried her best to save her country. Twice she was successful in her attack upon the hearts of her Roman conquerors. Then at last, Augustus defeated her army and planned to carry her away. In that period, she consumed poison and ended her life. From then onwards, Egypt became a province of Rome. Now let us view the Mesopotamian civilization. Mesopotamia is an area that lies in a valley between two rivers. The word Mesopotamia is an ancient Greek name as the land between two rivers. The two rivers are Euphrates and Tigris had made this West Asian barren land very fertile, in that many people are arrived and settled here, in that the Sumerians were the first ones to evolve a system of writing in Mesopotamia. Later, Sumerians, Babylonians, Assyrians, and Persians are arrived to this place. The northern part of Babylonia was called Akkad and the southern part Sumer. The northern part of Mesopotamia was known as Assyria. The history of Mesopotamia is a story of endless hatred and conflict. The Sumerians, the hilly tribe from the north, were the first to arrive here. They used to worship their gods on top of the hills. These were called ziggurats. The Jews called these the towers of Babel. The Sumerians had entered Mesopotamia in 4000 BCE, later Akkadians. After that, Amorites. The most famous king of the Amorites was Hammurabi. He framed the courts of justice and made Babylonia to be considered the best administered kingdom in the whole. Later came Hittites. After at last another Semitic tribe, that is Chaldeans. In that Nebuchadnezzar was the greatest king among them. He encouraged the study of science. But they also came under the attack of the Persians in the 6th century BCE. Later, Alexander transformed this place of the Semitic peoples into Greek province. Now let us view about the Chinese civilization. It is a special feature of all ancient civilizations that they were established on river plains. The river which led to the establishment of the Chinese civilization was known as China Saro. This was the Hang Ho River. The river Hang Ho was also known as the Saro of China because it often used to change its course after floods. This caused major damage to crops and canals dug for the purpose of irrigation. It also affected human life on a large scale and caused widespread distress. According to archaeological evidences, the first ruling family of the Chinese civilization was the Shang dynasty. It ruled in the period between the 18th century BCE and the 12th century BCE. The neighboring dynasty was Chao dynasty. In the Chao dynasty, there was a section of officials below the kings. The king allotted portions of land to the officials. In the lowest strata of social hierarchy were the slaves. The prisoners of war were made slaves by the kings. The Shang kings spent quite an amount of time in conquest and battles. Hence, the army was in prominence. The people of the Shang dynasty depended on agriculture. They had a well-organized system of irrigation. They used to grow plenty of rice. The Chinese used to wear thin cotton dresses. They used silk also. The Chinese used to make excellent pots. They believed that a dead man became a spirit and that the spirit had special powers. The dead body was buried along with various wooden articles, pots, bronze, vessels and other objects. The Chinese tradition of writing began with pictures and got transformed into an ideographic script.
Thank you for watching the video. If you really liked our video, click on the like button, share and do subscribe. From Gnanajyoti team, alone we can do so little, together we can do so much. For further information, kindly visit our website, that is www.gnanajyoti.in.